Hello friends, this is Tarun Kumar Das, working in Kendra Vidyalaya Koraput. Welcomes all of you for today's English class. And today's topic is Ribbon Winkle, Part 3 of Class 5 English. Friends, we have already discussed Part 1 of Ribbon Winkle and Part 2 of Ribbon Winkle, and this is Part 3 of Ribbon Winkle. In this part, I'm going to discuss about the silent letters in the words and the opposite words of very often used words and some creative writing as well as use of time related words. Friends, if you have not watched yet the Ribbon Winkle Part 1 and Part 2, you can watch it from my YouTube channel Tarun Kumar Das. So let's start the lesson today, Ribbon Winkle Part 3. Before going to the lesson, let us find out what are the objectives we are going to achieve after this lesson. And the objectives are: find the silent letters in words, understand the words awake, wake up, and get up, understand the use of the words always, usually, sometimes, never, often, frequently, like this. So friends, let's read Ribbon Winkle Part 3. Silent letters. Silent letters. Thumb. Christmas. Answer. School. Here you can find out, my dear friends, B-O-M-B. Here, the last B is silent. The color, it is in red color. And in Christmas, T is not pronounced. It is silent. And whenever we are pronouncing answer, we are not pronouncing W, because the sound of W is W, but we are not pronouncing. But here you can see S-C-H-O-O-L. And you know, the sound of H is H, but we are not pronouncing H. We are pronouncing school. So here H remains silent. So in the four words B, T, W and H often related silence. So dear friends, a silent letter is a letter that in a particular word does not correspond to any sound in the word's pronunciation. That means whenever we are pronouncing a word, these letters never make any sound. So we generally skip their pronunciation sound and we go to the sound of the word only. So these letters are called as the silent letters. So here are these are the examples. So let's start the related exercise with the silent letters. What is common in the following groups of words? K M E E knee. K N I F E knife. K N O T snot. K N O W no. So here we can find out the similarity that we are not pronouncing the letter K. So we are not pronouncing K. So the K, K remains silent. So here we are pronouncing knee, knife, not, and now. So here the common is K. Next, neighbor, daughter. Fight, straight. So fear, friends, here whenever we are pronouncing neighbor, N-E-I-G-G's sound is G, but we are not pronouncing G. Similarly, in daughter, G sound is G, but we are not pronouncing. F-I-G-H-T, fight, we are not pronouncing G. And in straight also, G has no sound. So here, the common is G. Next, honest. Honor, R, air. So here also H sound remains silent. So here the common is H sound and it remains silent. Try and make more silent letter words. G N A T is not. T-O-N-G-U-E, tongue. C-H-A-L-K, chalk. W-H-I-S-T-L-E, whistle. So here in the first word itself, G is not pronounced. It is in red color. Tongue. But we are pronouncing tongue. So we are skipping the sound of U and E. So here these two alphabets remain silent. Next, C-H-A-L-K, chalk, we are not pronouncing L. W-H-I-S-T-L-E, whistle, we are not pronouncing T. So we have to frame some more words related to the words like gnat, tongue, chalk, and whistle, where in the first case, G must be silent. In the second case, U, E must be silent. And in third case, L must be silent. And in the fourth case, T must be silent. So the words are side, here G is silent, align, design, foreign, campaign. So here G remains silent in almost all the five words. Next, we'll go proceed for the silent letters U and E. Mosque, league, dialogue, technique, unique. So here also UE remains silent. Next we will go for L silent words. Talk, walk, cough, calm, half. Next T silent words. Match, watch, wrestle, listen, Christmas. Okay, friends, let's go to the next topic. Opposites of the words awake, wake up, and get up. Read the two paragraphs given below. My mother is always awake before anyone else in the family. I usually wake up after 6 o'clock. I loll around lazily for a few minutes. Then I get up and get dressed for school. At bedtime, I read a storybook. When I feel tired, I lie down and go to sleep very quickly. I fall asleep in no time at all. So here, my dear friends, let me tell you. The words here already given in red color, like the words awake, wake up, and get up. No doubt these three words are related to an act of sleeping and getting up. So we will discuss here how should we use and when should we use the words like awake, wake up, and get up. Awake means it is the condition where the person or the body is not sleeping. And wake up means somebody is sleeping, but he has to stop sleeping, and that means leave sleeping. That is wake up. Next comes get up. Get up means no doubt you have to leave the bed, but you have to get ready. Get up means get ready. Next, asleep. Asleep means already sleeping. And lie down. Lie down means friend. It is in sleeping position, but not sleeping. Okay, so let's start. Do the exercises. Now, find the opposites of the following words from the paragraphs and complete the table. Awake, wake up, get up, and leisurely. So here, awake, the opposite will be asleep. Wake up, sleep. Get up, lie down, and leisurely will be quickly. Next exercise. Fill in the blanks using the words in the previous questions. Days and days quickly, you will be late for school. Shh, the baby eats days, Don't make a sound, or she will daze. Are you still daze? You should be daze now, or you will not be able to daze in the morning for school. So here in the first one, let us use the words from the paragraph. Wake up and get up quickly. You will be late for school. That means somebody is sleeping here and we are giving instruction that you please stop sleeping and get ready. Otherwise, you will be late for school. Next is that, shh, the baby is dazed. That means the baby is in a condition and we should not make a noise. If you will make a noise, then the baby will leave that position. So you can find out here, shh, the baby is asleep. That means the baby is already in sleeping position, sleeping mode. The baby is sleeping only. Don't make a sound or she will daze. She will wake up. That means she will stop sleeping. Next, are you still dazed? You should be dazed now or you will not be able to daze in the morning for school. That means somebody has gone already for sleeping, but he or she is not sleeping. So we can use here, are you still awake? That means you are not sleeping. You should be asleep. You should be asleep. That means you should be in sleeping position and you should start sleeping. Next, now or you will not be able to get up in the morning for school. That means you cannot get ready for going to school in the morning. Let's talk. Lots of things must have happened in the village when Rip was away. Imagine you are the neighbor who greets Rip after 20 years. One student should act as Rip. Tell Rip about all that had happened in the village after he left. For example, you can take talk about what happened to his family, to his friends, to the other villages, to the children he played with, the changes in the village, etc. You may start this way. Guess what happened on the day you left. When you didn't come home in the evening, your wife does this. That means start. You have to proceed here. Friends, Rip has already reached your home and you are the villager, you are the neighbor of Rip and Winkle, and as you are also grown up, you can ask Rip where was he. You can tell Rip about the condition of the village, about the condition of the people in the village, about the condition of the children in the village and the changes in the village. You can talk to Rip by describing almost all the things. So this will be one kind of creative writing. So let's proceed. You must start this way. Rip, guess what happened on the day you left? When you didn't come home in the evening, your wife searched you here and there. She asked everyone in the village about you. The children whom you were telling stories missed you very much. Your companion, Wolf, was also missing all along with you. Your farm was destroyed as no one was there to look after. Everyone in the village missed you a lot. So this way you can write. The speech bubbles, who walks to school most often, put them in order. Anu, I don't usually walk to school. I often go by cycle. John, I never walk to school. I live very far away. Arjun, I always walk to school. I live right opposite the school. Mini, I sometimes walk to school. At times I take the bus also. Naseem, I usually walk to school. It's a nice way to start the day. So friends, here I am going to tell you that everyone is going to school, but sometimes they are using in some way they are using this walking style, and somewhere they are using the school bus, or they are going by cycle like this. So we have to go through less who is walking to school most often. That means every time we have to go from order like this. So let me tell you, where should you use always, where should you use sometimes, and where should you use usually, and where should you use never, and where should you use don't usually. So friends, always means what? Always means at all times, or you can say every day, every time. And usually means generally. That means not all the time. It's less than the always position. Or you can say in a routine, just a schedule that I go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, but I don't go on Sunday. That means you can use usually. Then sometimes. Sometimes means not usually and not all the time also. It means occasionally. Next, don't usually. Don't usually, that means not generally. Next, never. Never means not at all. At no time. So let's start. Which one will come first? First will be always. I always walk to school. I live right opposite to the school. Number two, usually. Nazim, I usually walk to school. It's a nice way to start the day. Number three, I sometimes walk to school. At times I take the bus also. Next, number four, it is I don't usually walk to school. I often go by school, bicycle. So that means sometimes, very less time, Anu uses the walking. Okay. Next, John. Never. I never walk to school. I live very far away. Creative writing. Write about yourself using the following expressions. Do you play in the park? Go to bed late? Fuss over food? Study hard, etc. And the clues are always, frequently, usually, often, sometimes, and rarely. So let's understand where should you use always. Always means at all times. Frequently means regularly, but not every day. Usually means with a routine, in a routine time. Often means most of the time. Sometimes means not all time, occasionally. And rarely means not most of the time. Or we can say that can be used for as per the choice or as per the desire. So let's start. For example, I always do my work neatly. I frequently play in the park. I usually go to bed late. I often play with my friends. I sometimes study hard. I rarely fuss over food. Use the following clues to complete the following exercise. Play, stop, buy, learn, see. Meet, learn, be, eat, go, travel, start, read, visit. Write three new things you have done in the last 3 years. I have started reading storybooks in the last 3 years. I have visited Manali. I have stopped eating noodles. Now write three things you have not done in the last 3 years. I have not played football. I have not traveled to a desert. I have not met my best friend. So friends, if you like today's class, then you can hit the like button, the thumbs up button, then you can comment your views and you can share with your friends. If you have not subscribed to my channel, you can subscribe it and you can hit the bell icon so that you can be notified for my new videos. Next, you can follow me on https://tarunkumar.blogspot.com. So friends, thank you very much for being with me. I will be back with a new video for you. Till then, bye bye.